Hey everybody, it's JTB, and welcome back to The Run. This is going to be Chapter 12. Now, this is the first introduction of Laser Crab Fiends. These will pop up on Master Ninja. Now, if you've watched any of the previous videos, or any video that I've probably made over the last few years, you'll know that explosive arrows are extremely good against Laser Crab Fiends. If you've got the UF here, then if I remember rightly, I think the UT actually one-shots these. Even, you know, regular health, you don't need low health. These guys have a lot less health than normal, you know, for Laser Crab Fiends, probably due to you just fighting them a lot earlier. So, we'll wait for the other one to show up. Wherever he is. So there we go. One UT, just regular UF. That I don't even think I've got Armlet of the Sun on here. And that still takes them out. So, while they are pretty dangerous, they really don't have a lot of health compared to their, you know, like, late-game counterparts. That was extremely cheeky on that Laser Crab Fiend's part right there. In-air bow is fantastic here. Windrun, in-air bow with the explosive arrows. That fire managed to catch that guy as well. So in-air bow into Y with the UF as well is also a one-hit kill on them, so I really can't stress enough how good explosive arrows are, though, here. The in-air bow makes it super, super it's useful anyway, but the in-air bow just makes it downright OP, like, how good that is against Laser Crab Fiends. That's still going to hit him. Spawn camp these next two guys. The key is this way, isn't it? Yeah, so key's this way. Explosive arrows are really good in this fight in particular, just because if you saw that fire effect on the one I just did, it's got a really good chance of hitting multiple enemies here. I'm not sure I'm getting two guys, but like that. See, reuse auto aim when stuff is above him is, I wish it was that good when there wasn't things above him, but unfortunately, no dice on that one, I'm afraid. There we are. This should be the key. Yep. Again, the memory is not the best for all these items. There we go. So we'll go and do that. Now, you don't get any... Now, there's no Laser Crab Fiends in that fight. I just did, for some strange reason. I remember there... I feel like there should have been. But you do get Laser Crab Fiends here. You can chain essence from the rat that's near the Muramasa. Of course, if you're playing on Master Ninja and you've got the early Debilero... even if you didn't get it, you should have level 3 Inferno at this point. Well, you'll have at least one Nimpo level 3, and it probably should be Inferno. I knew that was greedy, but I did it anyway. One thing I haven't mentioned yet, you notice how that knocked me into a wall and did quite a bit more damage? That applies to you as well as the enemies. Like, if the enemies knock you into a wall, you will take considerably more damage from their attack. You'll see it on Laser Crab Fiends. You'll see it on the crab imps, actually, when they do that kind of scoop up attack where they, like, flip you up with their legs. If that knocks you into a wall, it will do considerably more damage than normal. Same with the clone when he does, you know, knockback attacks. Like, if you get knocked back into the wall, you'll take a lot more damage. So just something to keep in mind in situations like that where you can sometimes get greedy. And if you're not paying, like, if you're not really paying attention, you could easily get knocked into a wall. Just wait for this guy. Now, you can just charge ETs here, but... there we go. Wait for him to go back in. There we are. So, as long as you're about halfway here and you're facing him, you'll get that double connecting ET. And as you can see, that does a lot of damage. It is actually disturbingly fun to, like, full combo this guy with shurikens, because it is possible. be very careful getting the backflip here. I think I got one there. It's not a huge problem, but if you're going, you know, if you're going away from the worm and you try and backflip, then when he does the, you know, the kind of the swipe attack that he did just there, it can actually knock you out of that if you're not careful. I think that's a great spirit elixir. Much like very hard mode, there is an absolute ton of great spirit elixirs in this chapter. So if you leave any behind, keep them in mind for when you come back in chapter 16. Because you'll be coming back through here from the caverns. So you can pick any up that you missed. I think this is another great spirit elixir. This is Essence, I believe, NNG. Yeah, NNGB. Now you can hear the rat. So we'll swap over to our arrows here. This rat is clearly in league with the enemy, so we'll take him out. You just get crab imps here again. From this point in the game, you will see it, but the enemy encounters and patterns, it's very, very similar to Master Ninja from this point on. There really isn't a lot of difference. I think certain encounters might have like one or two more enemies, but other than that, the enemies that you're fighting and that are all pretty much identical. So it's pretty easy to remember the games in terms of their difficulties and differences, because there's just not many between Very Hard and Master Ninja. Like Normal Hard, Very Hard, there's quite a lot. Those three are all pretty unique. So here we'll get our Spirit of the Devil. See, look, this rat's definitely in league with the fiends. How else is he still alive? See, he respawned. He came back to life. It's just funny to try and hit him with the Dabiliro, because you can do it. Okay, that would have hit him. This rat's too smart. He's too smart. We'll leave him be. He deserves to live for that. So we'll pop in our Spirit of the Devils. You can, of course, go and do the Pillbug Challenge and the Pillbug Fight. I'll do the first fight, because off the top of my head, I can't actually remember what you get down there. I think it's a Jewel of the Demon Seal, but we'll go find out. We'll get some more Nimpo. We'll buy one of those. Refill our arrows. Now, there's three arrows in this chapter, but again, money's not really a huge problem. There we go. I know you'll get a lot of money in this chapter, even if you don't do any real farming, because the pillbugs are just worth a lot of essence just by themselves. Another great spirit elixir in that chest right there next to the save statue. Actually, I think this is a great too. Oh no, it is a Jewel of the Demon Seal. Right, we'll save that for Inazuma, because it's really good to have that as soon as we get Inazuma in chapter 15. Now, these guys, again, if you've got the Holy Gauntlet, which in theory you should have, I would highly recommend using it for this fight, because it will turn these guys into... they'll be worth 980 essence apiece when killed with the UT. And that is a lot of money, like almost a grand apiece for these guys. If you think about it, you know, there's 30 of them in this fight, and there's 120 of them in the Fiend Challenge. So if you're killing, you know, even half of them with UTs, and if you want to keep your combo going with shurikens, you know, you're killing half of them with UTs with a high combo, you know, you are going to get a pretty crazy amount of money out of just these two fights. And there we go. The reward for the Fiend Challenge is a talisman, if I remember rightly. But I'm not going to bother doing that, because it's pretty much just that fight again. It just takes longer. We'll go and do the red tablet here. I think this is a Life of the Gods. It's a Life of the Gods or a Great. Another Life of the Gods. Nice. We'll pop that in real quick. There we are. Another Scarab. And red tablet. So this is going to be Crab Imps, much like it is Very Hard. In these chapters is really where you'll start seeing... so you see there, you know, forward Y didn't kill that guy. It sometimes does with the Dabiliro, but just not always. Whereas the UF will kill every time. So that string, I think I mentioned that in the normal run, but that string's not actually in the Dabiliro's command list, the just XXY string. It is a really, really good string. It's very, very fast and really good knockback on that Y animation. I don't know why it's not in the command list. It's kind of weird. I don't think it's in the... You know what? I'll have to check. Because I think it's in the command list for the Dark Dragonblade, but I don't think it's in there for the Dabiliro. Now, there's no fight here on Master Ninja. I don't think there is on Very Hard in Black either, but on Black there is actually a fight in this room after you pick up that statue. That fight's not here in Sigma. It's a pretty tough fight because you'll get three laser crab fiends at the end of that encounter, like, you know, all at the same time. And three laser crab fiends in such a an enclosed arena is not the easiest thing to manage. So it's I guess a little nerf that they took that out of this version. That's not in original Sigma either. That's not a Master Collection thing. It's just not in Sigma. The Ghostfish are, though. So whip out flails. Kill these. Again, you can get some really easy points with Warhammer UTs here if you want to pepper in some more points. If you're doing both Fiend Challenges, though, points really shouldn't be a concern in this chapter, really. You'll get tons of points out of those. We've got some passive fish here. There we go. Alright, so we missed out on one kill. That was weird. Should be 30. Grab our scarab. And we've got to fight the double worms. You'll really kind of see the similarities in, you know, very hard Master Ninja. So we've got a cheeky fish coming towards us. So we'll... okay, I was trying to time my block there to try and get these UTs. So if you want to UT the fish, again, just wait for them to come towards you. And then release your UT and press Y. You don't want to do it too early because then you'll cut off those iframes and then you'll get hit. So... couple of extra UTs there. UTs on fish really do add up, you know, over the course of an entire fight and especially the entire game. If you're getting sort of like 5 to 6 UTs out of a ghost fish fight over the course of the whole game, that really will mount up to a lot of points. So there, sometimes they are a bit cheeky and they will do that instead of like doing the swoop, and then you won't get your combo. That's probably low health UF. I wasn't paying attention though. Might not be low health, but yeah. So you notice how my my health bar's not pulsating. So I'm not doing like max damage, but I'm still doing a you know, a pretty sizable chunk here with just one forward Y. So if you get down to low health, you may as well use it. Generally speaking, on like first runs, I wouldn't advise going low health unless you've got at least one talisman, because then if you make a mistake, it's no big deal. So there, I'm not really going to worry about that. Keep my Nimpo handy. Man, he came out right into that. What a dumbass. So here, it'd be nice to get a UT kill on this guy. There we go. The low health UF UT is just kind of disgusting. How much damage it does. It's fun though. It's a lot of fun. Right, we're gonna pop in. I'm gonna pop in a great here because I mean, I say this. I can already think of, I think, 4 off the top of my head that I can go back and get. So it's not really a big deal. That's another thing on the higher difficulties. Pretty sure I mentioned it in very hard, but the amount of greats that the game throws at you in the higher difficulties, which is somewhat ironic, is pretty crazy. So you might as well use greats as your like main way of healing for the most part once you get to this point in the game. Because the game is not only going to give you them back for free, but you'll also be able to heal for, you know, it's better to heal just 100% instead of healing, like, a little bit at a time and then having to buy loads of smalls. Now that I think about it, that's something that I have actually seen people do, is that they will burn, like, 3 or 4 regular elixirs instead of using a great on the higher difficulties because, you know, the enemies hit a lot harder on the higher difficulties, so you need to heal for more health. But, as I said, because there's so many free Great Spirit Elixirs on Very Hard and Master Ninja, you know, you're better off just using those and then saving those little ones, because then it saves you a lot of money. Because the little ones, I think, are... I think they're 2,000 a piece at Muramasa, and if you're buying 5 of them, you know, every, say, twice per chapter, like, that's a lot of money. It's a lot of essence you're burning through, and you don't need to. I think we've got another... Actually, no, I think this is a regular elixir, isn't it? Yeah, it is. Right, we'll leave that behind. But case in point, you know, that's one regular elixir, and yet I think there's 5 greats in this chapter. 25 seconds, that's a pretty short time limit for this ghost fish fight. Oh, he gave us an info, that's nice. We like that, so again, just good old jump X into XXX. Do not button mash here. Use very precise amounts of presses for your combos. You don't want that combo to... Because that's one of the worst rooms to get tagged by fish in, because they're so far apart, it's really, really common for them to just actually, like, just drain your whole health bar just by ticking away at you little by little. So here, the fight will be over, I think, once you kill all the wasps, if I remember rightly. So, there we go. That's nice. I was able to get all the points there. You can still kill them and get credit for the kills. You just, if you're cut off the fight early, of course, you won't get credit for any more UTs. And you can actually get a lot of UTs out of that fight if you use the Warhammer and really, like, you know, because, I mean, you can use the Dabilaro like I did just there and just kind of plow through it. I thought I was anticipating a load screen there, and we didn't get one, which was strange. I think I bought all my... Incendiary's back. Another great in that chest. Okay, I'm missing some crab imps here, which I seem to remember there should be, but never mind. There's a great in that chest, so you're low on health, you can grab one there. Let's just visit our good old buddy Muramasa. He's got some more stuff, more shit for us. So on Master Ninja, you'll notice the Scarab rewards, once you get past 20, are all kind of bad. There's no other way to say it, really. You basically get item equivalents from Muramasa, so you'll get they're actually the same items that you get in Ninja Dog. So you'll get like Ayane's rations, you'll get Ayane's devil potions or whatever they're called. I can't remember what they're called off the top of my head. That will refill your Nimpo. In a way, it's actually a bit of a buff, because you can actually hold more items than you would normally on Very Hard, because Very Hard has, you know, similar item limits to Master Ninja. But on Master Ninja, you get all those extra items from Muramasa. So you can hold sort of 6 regular Devil Elixirs, like, in a way, in a manner of speaking, because you have them. But you won't get any more, like, greats or anything like that for the regular ones. I think this is a... Yep, another great Spirit Elixir. So, doing pretty good on those. I'm just going to check my talismans real quick to see... see how we're doing on them. I've got 2. Okay, so I might low health UF Jotunfrau then, because why not indeed? Yeah, see, so that killed him. That does not counter. Fiend Sealer him. Good example there. I may go into a bit more detail on that in another video, but just stuffing enemy attacks, knowing when they're going to commit to things, it's something you really have to have a lot of just experience on. But it is really, really good, because I think there's a bit of a misconception that you can't do it with slow moves, but you can stuff it with whatever you want, really. Okay, so that Hall of Balance is in the menu. It really wants us to know where we are. So again, this rat, or fiend, should I say, you know, in league with the devil. Here, I'm going to try and get the Gleaming Blade opener on the clone. It's tricky to get, especially in Sigma, because he's just a cheat. But what you want to do, get to here and then jump forward, so you have a little bit more space covered between you and the clone. And immediately jump forward and shuriken. Sometimes he will just shoot you out of the air. It really does depend on what kind of day he's having. There we go. Oh yeah, he was an absolute wise guy. Well, I can do that too, my friend. Yeah, he tends to do this. Pretty annoying. He'll just nimpo, like, whenever you nimpo. and just, you know, completely nullify it, which is kind of strange. Right, so here, we'll just do good old XY against this guy. I don't want to be far away from him like that, because he'll try and shoot me. I have a feeling he's going to be a real wise guy. I mean, if the first hit is connecting, it's fine. It's just sometimes he will nimpo out of that. There we go. Nope. Now, I want my Devil Elixirs here again, just in case he's a wise guy. Okay, he's not quite got us on. If he puts you to low health, that's exactly what I was talking about. You know? Okay, that's low health, so I'm going to Nimpo here. And hopefully, he's probably just going to guillotine throw me, but no. There we go. Oh, that's satisfying to do. So as I said, in Sigma, you are better off doing the instant wall attacks. So, you know, against clones, I mean. So don't do bird flip. They usually just block bird flip. And one thing they tend to do off of bird flip as well is they will nimpo you. So they'll block the kind of ground pound effect. So as I've said before, like when you do the bird flip attack, you get that ground pound. And if they're next to you, say on your left or right, they'll block that. And then they'll just immediately nimpo. And more often than not, that nimpo will hit you. And also, because you're quite close, just from the nature of it being, you know, right next to you, if you're near a wall, then it can be quite tricky to actually get out of the way of the nimpo blast, you know, if he does Inferno. So here, I just thought, if you want to get a few extra points, you can just stand here and charge UTs with the good old Debilero. These guys can't come past here. I can't remember exactly where their limit is, but it's pretty far. Like, you have to be past that, where Ryu's foot was just then. You have to be, like, over that for these guys to be able to come and bite you. The main reason I'm doing this as well is because I don't want to mess up my low health for the Debilero. For the UF, rather. So I'm going to pop an Elixir there. We'll swap over to Fire Wheels. because I don't want to actually lose the points here. There we go. Burn that. I love that noise. And we'll grab our Life of the Gods. So here, I'm going to show a couple of things with the low health UF. Again, refer to my other notes on the difficulties. If you don't want to use it, then for berserkers, for ogres, I keep getting those mixed up lately, and I don't know why. For ogres, just roll under whatever they do, forward Y. Like, it, you know, it works with any heavy weapon. It's just, you know, the UF, the low health UF being so strong, you know, you'll see that. I think it's a 2-hit kill from what I remember. So, see what he does. Roll under it, forward Y, dude's dead. If you get a UT in the back like that, more often than not, it will kill them. It won't always kill them. In-air XXXX with Armor of the Sun on will also kill these guys. Another thing you can do is like in-air X, and then you can do an on-landing UT. That will take them out. See what this guy does. You can do that into forward Y. That'll kill them. And the good old batter up. Oh, that string is just so cool. And there we go. We want to keep our low health here. So grab this scarab. So I'm gonna low health Pazu. I'll low health him, but I'll do a relatively safe way of low healthing him, because you can just totally YOLO him and just walk up to him and do like the full blade of Nariti string and hope it hits. The only problem with that is if he does, you know, like vertical laser, or he does a swoop or stomp, then you'll just get nailed like right out of the gate and you'll burn a talisman, which is not really ideal. I'm not too worried about money though, because we've got the fish coming up, you know, at the beginning of chapter 13, and as I've said on every other run, like you just print money from those guys, so you really don't need to worry too much about money at this point in the game. So what we'll do for Pazu, we'll swap to smoke bombs just in case we need them for the minions. I'll go to Inferno to start with, because if I get in a bad spot with regards to his laser, it's much easier to just Inferno for the invulnerability. And more than likely, it'll probably kill at least one minion as well. But we're not going to do anything flashy on Pazu. You don't really need to. Ironically, the low health UF can be used extremely safely, provided you you know how. So there, I'm just going to smoke bomb, nimpo these guys. I only killed one, never mind. Okay, so here, jump forward, see what he does, wait for that. And that actually hit him in the head, so we got full damage on that. So he's going to do that. That's going to kill that minion. Windrun to find this guy, because the camera angle here, again, can be quite tricky. So, Windrun to find him. Don't go past there so he doesn't drop down. We still have a UT there, so. There we go, and I'm going to wait for the UT iframes, I'm going to wait to press buttons, because otherwise that slide would have hit me, and then you can just do jump in air XXXX, or square, 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 and then you'll get the full Blade of Nariti string on Pazu. So, there again, like, you can use the low health UF and stay relatively safe as long as you just kind of know what you're doing. I may use it on Doku, again, just for fun, because it's guaranteed to hit him in this game. And there we go, that's chapter 12. So, no fiend challenges, still got Master Ninja. Just kind of shows you, you know, you'll be down somewhere in the region of, say, 600 to 800,000 points if you don't do the fiend challenges. So, you know, the margins for that are pretty generous. There's also a triple boss in that chapter too, so that does kind of lend itself to, you know, getting a lot of money, getting a lot of points, rather, from that chapter. So here, we'll just kill these first few fish with celerity, because it just makes the charges easier. I think you can get 9 fish here, so you could literally get 100 grand out of these guys if you, if you wanted to. You could just kill them. You could just wait and kill them all with UTs. So there, we'll get a double kill. Now, that will give us one extra fish. And I believe if you go and do the same thing at the other end, you'll get another fish. Now, I should have an essence there that I can just grab. Like that. Charge again. There's his buddy. Kill him. So even though I'm absorbing essence here, these essence are worth so much. Like, I'm still getting a decent amount of money out of these. I believe these are 2 grand base, so just from absorbing essence, you know, I'm still getting 2,800 from the ones I'm using for UTs. So, and I collected 2 there, so there we go, look at that. That was 40 grand without really breaking a sweat. Pretty mental. So there's another grate in that chest on the left or right. I can never remember which one it is. Let's find out. It's the right. So there's another grate there. So plenty of health. We'll swap over to our arrows. This chapter, again, is more or less exactly the same as Very Hard. So I hope this helps, guys. I will catch you in chapter 13. Peace.